Roller derby fans, the bronze medals are on the line. Good evening. I'm Vince Hannity, along with Shut the Fred Up, and you are watching the 2017 International Wftda Division II Playoffs and now Third Place Championship live, brought to you from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, by the Women's Flat Track Derby Association and Steel City Roller Derby. This game will be between the Naptown Roller Derby Tornado Sirens, currently seated number 12 and ranked 53, and Dublin Roller Derby's charter team, ranked number 58 and seated number 16, live from the David L. Lawrence Convention Center. Fred.
Come the day and come the hour for Dublin. They have played four games to reach this final for the third place. Well, first win versus Old Ricky, 200, 183. Second win versus No Coast, 166, 165. Third win versus Naptown yesterday, 161, 158. And they lost the semi-final against Paris this morning, 259, 152. And now the rosters for Dublin with number 169, Brewdoll E. Lockhart, number 17, 13 is Louis, number 23 Bloody Harry, number 3 Voldemort, number 490 Malibu Stassi, number 53 Algy Bargy, number 575 Pippa, number 7 Ellie Beating, number 74 Stabba, number 8 Chancleta, number 800 Thea, 83 Dashing Through the Snow, 90 Lana Payne, 95 Mania, and four players couldn't make it to Pittsburgh this weekend, but they are in the hearts of Dublin players. It's Destroy McClure, Kira Powell, Katie Rex, and Flick.
We will have the roster for the Tornado Sirens at the end of our first jam. If you're just joining us, the Tornado Sirens of Naptown are in the black jerseys, Dublin's charter team in the blue jerseys. First jam about to get underway. It will be Dashing Trudy Stowe for Dublin, and no surprises from the Tornado Sirens, 237 Scorpio Pathic with the star for Naptown. Naptown at the rear of the scrum, Dublin charter team at the front. Coming up the inside lane is Scorpio Pathic, meeting the entire brace of Dublin. Entire brace of Naptown at the rear, slowing back. Snowy hit out and draw back, and that is a jammer penalty on Scorpio Pathic. Power jam for Snowy, but she is drawn back to the jammer line. Goes to the outside, but defended out by Cherry Auto Fire 07. Goes for a second pass. Held up by that brace. Almost 40 seconds gone in the jam. And outside in front, that's the lead jammer call for Dublin.
This is the lead jammer after more than 40 seconds of play. And we have Trudy Snow in the scoring trip right now. The importance of the first scoring trip is always here, and Dublin has it.
Dublin starts the scoring pass for Snowy with the pack for Naptown just past the pivot line in turn number one. Bringing in offense, that's the pivot, Mania, number 95, trying to help out with the offensive block, digging in. Number 95, Mutant Gene for the Tornado Sirens, trying to avoid a penalty, and that will be Manny sent to the 888 penalty box. Hit out and draw back on Scorpio Pathic as Snowy trying to take the Naptown brace triangle into turn number two. Finally breaks it out, goes to the outside for a grand slam, Fred.
This is it. The first points of the game are being scored by Dublin. We know that yesterday's game ended up with only 3-point difference, so any single point is going to count in that final for the third place.
And the star is past the active scorer for the Tornado Sirens, their pivot, Cherry Auto Fire, but Snowy will break the pack for one more pass. Call it off for a 9-0 jam to start scoring, Fred.
You know what? No disrespect with Naptown, because they played beautifully, but Dublin may have lost a game this morning, but have won hearts here in Pittsburgh all along the weekend. Everybody was cheering for them on all their games, and really, really, they won hearts of the audience here.
My learned colleague speaks truth, as Dublin, the Cinderellas of the Division II playoffs and championships. Jam number two underway. Made in America with a star for the Tornado Sirens in black. Bloody Harry, number 23, with a star for Dublin's charter team in the blue. Pivot for Dublin being sent off to the 888 penalty box as Made in America stretches the pack into turn number two. Two while trying to hold things out in the inside lane of turn number two, straightaway number two, but that's Made in America with the call, Fred.
This is the reply from Naptown and Made in America to Dublin. First jam was controlled by Dublin. Second jam is controlled by Naptown.
Naptown up front, Dublin at the rear of the pack as Made in America starts her scoring pass. Works the toe stops on the lateral movement, saved with the hit out by number 74, Staba. Drawn back to turn number two. Brace triangle. Doesn't quite catch her on the inside lane, as that is confirmed. Grand slam, Made in America.
This time, Staba couldn't make it, couldn't stop Made in America. She tried to repeat the same gesture on the inside with a hips meme, but Made in America had it all and scored all the points. It's another tie, 9-9, 26 minutes and 33 seconds left at this fourth. The first half.
Hashtag Fred effect.
There's no Fred effect. There's only the player's awesomeness effect on the track. As all along those 3 days, the level of play was absolutely high. The games were just mental. It was just a pleasure to announce those games.
Indeed. Thea, number 800, the jammer of record for Dublin. For Naptown's Tornado Sirens, it is number 501, Darth Blue. Tornado Sirens being taken over the pivot line by Thea. Stretching into turn number one. Thea about center of the boundaries. Tries to go outside. Defended by number 27, R.I.P. McMurphy. Buys enough time for Darth Blue to sneak inside. And Fred, that's lead jammer Naptown.
It's 2-1 for Naptown on lead jammer. But look at the walls and the tripod from Naptown. They have a very good mobility, lateral mobility from the left to the right. And they were able to contain Thea's attack, allowing Darth Blue to take the lead on that jam number three.
Thea will finally break the pack on her initial pass with 38 seconds of the jam gone. Darth Blue gets will get all 4 points in the pass, which will bring us, with three jams gone, a score of Naptown's Tornado Sirens 13, Dublin Charter Team holding at 9.
I believe this is the first time that Naptown has taken the lead on that game, but it's a very close and very narrow lead, only by 4 points. Jam number four upcoming.
It will once again be snowy with the star for Dublin. For your Tornado Sirens, they will go once again with Scorpio Pathic. Both teams content to run the three-jammer rotation for tonight's third-place game.
Once again, look at the tripod for Naptown, putting Snowy at the back of the pack. Really solid, solid moves from Naptown. And we have Scorpio Pathic on top and taking the lead for Naptown.
Nice move by Scorpio Pathic, cutting through on the inside lane of turn number one as the pack goes over the pivot line, and Scorpio Pathic starts her first scoring pass against all four blockers. Snowy with the star stash will break the pack on her initial pass, and that will be a call off by the Tornado Sirens.
It's now three leads for Naptown versus one for Dublin. Dublin had the first lead, but since jam number two, Naptown has controlled all the jams here. It's 15 for Naptown, 9 for Dublin.
Just over 24 minutes left in the regulation in first period, with star for the Tornado Sirens in black. It is once again Made in America. And for the Dublin Charter Team, it is Bloody Harry as we are underway. Tornado Sirens rear of the scrum, Dublin up front. Penalties being called to the 888 penalty box. It's Mania, but a cutting the track on Made in America turns this into a Bloody Harry power jam for the Dublin Charter Team. Cherry on a fire, not appearing on your screen, draws her back to turn number four behind the jammer line. Now coming in for the initial pass, hit out once again by the pivot Cherry on a fire of the Tornado Sirens, drawn back midway between the jammer and pivot line, and also being held up by Bruzy Ricardo. Dublin trying to send in blockers to help, but Bruzy Ricardo and Chariot of Fire, Fred, just a force of nature on Harry.
I believe that this is the second time that Dublin beneficiates for a power jam, and the first time was on the first jam, and they scored 9 points. So let's see what's Bloody Harry going to do with that.
Well, power jam now killed, as that will be Made in America back on the track. Neither jammer finally lead, but it's showing lead as the lead jammer.
She thought that she was called, actually, but she was just awarded the lead jammer position.
She was awarded lead jammer. The outside pack ref, Roger Jamby, had made a signal for cutting the track, but waved off by the jam ref. Calls it off after completing the initial pass, but I believe the damage, no damage done, a scoreless jam, so we will hold at 15-9.
It may happen in the game, and especially after 3 days, you have the fatigue and you're not totally focused on the ref calls here. And this is exactly what happened on that jump number five.
Indeed, Fred, both these teams in their fifth game of the weekend. I can only imagine what game of the weekend this is for our officiating crew tonight.
And one advantage that Naptown may have on Dublin, but they play beautifully, is that Dublin arrived on Wednesday, and they may still be affected by the jet lag.
Tornado Sirens will mix up the jammer rotation with number 17, Critical Velocity. First time with the star, getting swarmed by Dublin's pack at the rear of the scrum. Thea trying to take the three frontmost Tornado Siren blockers into turn number two. Straightaway number two on the outside lane, coming in for assistance is Malibu Stacy.
And Thea is trying to get on the inside, but the door is closed by Naptown blockers. The lead jammer position is for Dublin now, and Thea, and I believe this has been the third lead jammer position since the beginning of the game for Dublin.
You, sir, are correct, and Thea moving towards the pack to try and score. Front of the pack is the Tornado Sirens. Dublin trying to get up front, maybe catch the goat to get a point. Called off. Does she catch it in time? No!
No, not in time. Only one pawn despite the lead jammer position for Dublin and four pawn for Naptown. That's why Naptown jammer had their hands in the air.
Indeed, six jams down. Naptown Tornado Sirens 19, Dublin Charter Team 10. Call it 20 minutes and 45 seconds left in the first. Going into jam number seven, it will be Mania number 95. It will be Scorpiopathic 237 for Naptown. And just like that, Fred, one step outside and gone is Mania for the lead jammer call.
Despite having two blockers from Dublin in the 2.8 penalty box, Mania managed to find the necessary resources to take the lead jammer position on that jam number seven.
Mania already on her first scoring pass with only 15 seconds gone in the jam, trying to make up for lost time. No pack declared by the official. Mania will call it off part way. And she will be awarded with, if I see our jammer correctly, 3 points.
Mania has impressed a lot of people in the audience in Pittsburgh, but not only in the audience, but also on WFTD.TV. She's spoken a lot on social networks on the last 3 days.
Well, she certainly earned all the attention on social media with outstanding play. About to go into jam number eight. It will once again be Made in America for the Tornado Sirens and for the Dublin Charter Team, Snowy. But again, one step outside and gone is Made in America, Fred.
Yeah, an early lead jammer position for Naptown, and they have 6 point advantage now on that jam number eight. And let's see what Made in America. She's ducking and she resists the assault of number eight from Dublin Chancleta, and her second scoring trip now for Made in America.
She will be saved with a hit out and drawback. That is courtesy of Stab of the Pivot for the Dublin Charter Team. Trying to go inside, doesn't quite have the angle, but gets an assist from her teammate. I believe that was Chancleta once again.
Exactly, but Made in America still resists and still in control of that jam number eight. Let's see whether she's going to score more points for Naptown in that second scoring trip.
Snowy with a star stash against all four Tornado Siren blockers. A lot of pain coming in to try and get an offensive lane open. Snowy goes outside, goes inside, still not finding the lane.
Very good defending by Chancleta on Made in America. She made her lose the precious seconds on that jam. Number eight, I think. I can't see. There's a bit of wind on the scoreboard, so I can't see it. It's there. The jam number eight. 10 points now for Made in America. 29 for Naptown. 13 for Dublin.
Pack at the exit of turn number two, going into straightaway number two. Hop, skip, and a jump, but defended by Naptown. No points for Made in America, but the damage done. No points for Dublin, so that jam will end with a score of Naptown Tornado Sirens 29, Dublin Charter Team 13, 18 minutes and 7 seconds left in the first.
A 16-point advantage for Naptown, who, according to me, according to what I saw yesterday, appeared to be a bit more consistent than yesterday's game.
Well, consistency certainly showing up for Naptown in these last couple of jams as they will send out Darth Blue with the star to take on number 23, Bloody Harry's. Tornado Sirens again with that brace at the front of the scrum. Dublin Charter Team at the rear. Darth tries to go inside, swarmed, but finds a hole up the middle, and Fred gets the lead jammer call again.
Darth Blue lead jammer in that jam number nine, and she skates faster and faster to get the most point possible on the outside, resisting the attacks, getting on the inside, but the door is closed. And Darth Blue passes the pack once again to score more points for Naptown.
Pack at the exit of turn number two, going into straightaway number two. Darth Blue calls it off. Does she catch it in time? Yes, she will. 4-0 jam advantage Tornado Sirens to bring us to a score of 33, Naptown, Dublin 13, under 17 minutes left in the first.
Under 17 minutes left in the first in an upcoming jam number 10. That means that the jams are quite average. That means that it's very difficult most of the time for the jammers to take the lead, strong defending from the blockers. But as soon as the lead is being taken, there's only one or two scoring passes and not more.
For jam number 10, it will be Scorpio Pathic for the Tornado Sirens. Thea for the Dublin Charter team. Thea trying to go up the middle. Scorpio Pathic trying to find a lane, but it's inside. Turn number one. Thea gets the call, Fred.
I think that it's been a long time since Dublin didn't have the lead jammer. Thea is in control of that jam number 10. And now ready to score more points for the Blues on the outside. Getting back on the inside, immediately calling it as she saw that jammer number 07, Cherry of Fire, was coming over.
Indeed, keep an eye out for us calling that name and number 07, Cherry out of Fire of the Tornado Sirens. Do not be surprised to see her take the star at the beginning of the jam and via a star pass.
Despite the point difference, both Naptown and Dublin had 5 leads each before the upcoming jam number 11. But with 2 jammer penalties for Naptown.
Made in America once again with the star for the Tornado Sirens. Dashing Trudy Snow will jam once again for Dublin's charter team. Maiden taking the Dublin pack into turn number one, dances around the inside lane, gets the call, Fred.
Maiden America in her scoring trip right now. The pack is focused, but Maiden America is even more focused on taking on the outside to score 5 more points, a grand slam, 5 high in the sky for Naptown.
And Snowy still yet to break the pack on the initial pass, but courtesy of Valdemort and a second Dublin blocker, saving a second scoring pass, and the star has passed as Manny, now your active scorer for Dublin's charter team.
Have you seen the footwork from Mania on the track? It's always an amazing experience to see Mania skating backwards on a jam.
Well, if I recall correctly, Mania Spanish for power, but in that case, Fred, Mania should have been Spanish for grace.
Yes, and Chancleta is Spanish for weapon, as far as I reckon. 10 points for Naptown through Maiden America on the previous jam. 43 for Naptown, 15 for Dublin. Let's have a pause. Talking about AAA helmets, pads, wrist guards, we've got you covered.
Back underway, critical velocity. Naptown has decided she will figure into a 4 jammer rotation, perhaps jamming in relief for the Tornado Sirens. Hit out is Bloody Harry. She is not lead due to a no pass, no penalty. That was a Naptown blocker down on all fours, so no cutting the track penalty. A forearm penalty, however, will send off critical velocity to the 888 penalty box. And Fred, we've got a power jam.
I think it's been the third jammer penalty since the beginning of the game for Naptown. They really have to fix something if they don't want to see Dublin coming over at the scoreboard. Power jam for Bloody Harry.
Indeed, once you have your opponent down, do not let your opponent back into the game. Can the Tornado Sirens kill another power jam? Dublin trying to bring the heat.
Yeah, but despite the fact that Naptown had 3 jammer penalties, they have approximately a bit less than 30 points advantage. That means that the blockers are doing an amazing job on the track.
4 points on the pat, or excuse me, no, the thumb is out, I stand corrected. That is the full grand slam.
Yep.
4 parry on the first scoring pass. Out of the darkness, into the light, critical velocity, done with her jammer penalty. Pack now in turn number 3. Both jammers being held up. Critical still on her initial pass, but the star now passed. So now your active scorer for the Tornado Sirens, number 5, Trudy Balchery.
This is the end of the power jam on that jam number 12. We will have Trudy Butchery and Bloody Harry. The jam is going to go until its natural end here. And let's see how the two jammers are going to cope with it.
Rambam with a hit out and drawback. On Bloody Harry. Harry with the star cap off, but this is a scoring pass. I don't know if this is a tactical error here, Fred, especially being down 23 points.
Once again, we don't know how a players react after having played five games. And it's a power jam for Naptown for cutting the track just at the very last seconds of the previous jam. 22 for Dublin, 46 for Naptown, but a power start upcoming for Naptown.
The last thing that Dublin wants to see at this point.
Let's have a look at the penalties for the moment for Naptown. Shivadeva has two, and Chinkleta has two as well. Mania has two as well.
Scorpio Pathic on the power start formation for your Tornado Sirens. One blue jersey to beat, and she does lead jammer Naptown.
Life is good for Naptown for the moment. Power jam, early lead jammer situation. Scorpio Pathic ready to score more points for Indianapolis.
Already on her first scoring pass with the pack just moving into turn number two, being held up by the pivot. Brudali Lowcock coming into straightaway number two, shrugs off a blocker. One blue jersey to beat, gets outside, and that's the grand slam, Fred.
Did you see how Scorpio Pathic was using her toes to pass at the pack? She's always doing that when she's up front. She's trying to sneak into the tiniest little hole of the pack.
And Scorpio Pathic completes the second scoring pass. Will be awarded four on that pass. Total of nine on the jam. Done with her jammer penalty is Bloody Harry. Still with the star stash coming into straightaway number one, but not getting any space. Wham Bam trying to go for the drawback, but not quite out of, well, that will be Harry yielding to avoid another cutting the track penalty.
Once again, despite the three jammer penalties awarded to Naptown, it seems to me it is a very consistent start of the game for Naptown. Let's start because we have 10 minutes left on the first half, but Naptown is really, really focused on winning that medal, bronze medal. 19 points so far. I believe this is the highest number of points scored on one single jam in this game. And the award goes to Scorpio Pathic.
Indeed. And Dublin has passed the star. Now, your active scorer will be number 169, Brudali Lowcock. But the jam is called off. And Dublin, no surprise, Fred, will call team timeout.
Yeah, we say that it was a very consistent first half for the moment for Naptown. And logically speaking, Violent Bob is calling for a timeout to try to fix things up. And in the meantime, let's talk about Rydell. RydellSkates.com, make your skates your own with custom-colored, handcrafted Color Lab boots by Rydell Skates. What do you think, Vince, of the start of Naptown? Do you also think that they were very consistent?
Well, I have to give them credit for the consistency with Fred is the killing of the power jams. As you point out, multiple jammer penalties against the Tornado Sirens early on, I'd say in the first, let's call it dozen jams, but almost to an athlete, not a single point yielded to Dublin on those power jams. Whereas this previous jam we just had, jam number 13, at least a grand slam yielded by Dublin to the Tornado Sirens.
And let's remind our viewers that Naptown had three jammer penalties against them, and still they are leading 69-22. Once again, we will never underline the amazing work of the blockers on the first half so far.
Indeed, 9 minutes 59 seconds left in regulation in the first. Once play resumes, it'll be number 95, Mania, for Dublin's charter team, and it will be Made in America number 76 for your Naptown Tornado Sirens. If you're just joining us, number one, why? Number two, Naptown in the black jerseys, and Dublin in the blue jerseys.
Let's see whether the team timeout asked by Dublin is going to be beneficial for the blue team. Mania is still struggling with the pack on the outside, and it wasn't beneficial for Dublin as Mania is sent to the penalty box for a forearm, and she was also awarded an insubordination, so it's going to be a 1 minute power jam for Naptown. Amazing weapon here for Naptown to fly high at the scoreboard. They already have 47 point advantage here, and it's going to be a 1 minute power jam. And Made in America is going to try to make the most of the situation here for Naptown.
Tornado Sirens will go passive Dublin at the front of the pack, entering into straightaway number one, hit out and defended by Chancleta, but not quite enough momentum to get Maiden all the way out on the outside edge of the boundary line. But that second hit on the inside lane of turn number one, hit out and drawback, will do the trick all the way back to the jammer line.
There's also something that we need to remind our viewers is that this morning on the semifinal, Naptown suffered quite a big loss on the semifinal versus Boston, and they may be willing to give another face to their fans here in Pittsburgh and on stream on this final for the third place. That's maybe why Naptown seems to be flying high on this first half.
But flying high on the initial pass is number 95, Mania, finally breaking on the initial pass. There is no lead jammer. The clock cannot be stopped. Already going for the first scoring pass. Gets around the outside, but defended by number 51, Bruzy Ricardo. Jam ends on 2 minutes. And they will send off number 95, Newton Jean, to the 888 penalty box for Naptown.
It's a tie on that jam, number 14. 5-all. 5 for Naptown, 5 for Dublin, 27 for Dublin, 74 for Naptown. 7 minutes and 34 seconds left. Just in time for me to talk to you about 888, the sponsor of the penalty box. 888, new helmets that protect against rotational violence with MIPS, patented braid protection system.
And dashing Trudy Snow, dashing Trudy Pack for lead jammer for Dublin, Fred.
Exactly. Snowy is lead jammer on that jam number 15. Let's see whether it's going to be a prolific jam for the blue jammer. Oh, look at that good defending from number 07, Chariot Fire. And this is the end of that jam. 4 more points for Dublin.
Fred, I don't think we can emphasize enough the play that 07 Chariot of Fire of the Tornado Sirens has done all weekend long.
That's quite simple. In order to win a game, you need tremendous jammers, obviously. Naptown have them. But all you also need, once for all, tremendous blockers. Naptown have them. And clearly, Chariot Fire impersonates the extremely talented jammer here.
Indeed. Jam number 16 underway. Scorpio Pathic with the star will get the lead jammer call coming into turn number one.
Scorpio Pathic ready to score more points for Naptown. One in that turn number one right now. Look at the way she stuck the pack on the outside of the track, opening the door to the inside. She immediately rushed into it. This is a very classical but clearly effective work from Scorpio Path.
Violent Bob.
Pathic, sorry.
No problem. Violent Bob in center track to talk things over with our head referee, Silence of the Jams, and possibly our jam refs, Roll Bar. And I believe that's Kieran Duncan, but apparently satisfied with the explanation, so we'll get back underway with jam number 17, Made in America for Naptown, and Mania once again for Dublin's charter team.
You may wonder about the Spanish sound of Mania in an Irish squad. It's because Mania comes from Argentina, just like Chancleta.
I was going to say the Irish-Argentinian contingent, but she call her lead jammer this jam, Fred.
Mania is lead jammer on that jam number 17. Let's see what she's going to make out of it. She's already approaching the pack right now. Oh, beautiful footwork once again from Mania. Clearly, she was looking for the multiplayer block here, and she exploded the back right in the middle, and she calls on that jam. But on the flip side, you had the jammer from Naptown who already scored 3 points. 36 for Dublin, 80 for Naptown, 4 minutes and 42 seconds to go.
And the question, Fred, was that error by Mania not to call it off sooner and allow the points by Made in America with already such a big Tornado Siren lead?
At that level, a game is played on the details, and effectively, that might be the detail that's going to matter at the end of the game. You need to call a jam at a very precise moment.
Indeed. And out of the pack is Critical Velocity for Naptown. She is not lead jammer. Sole eligibility goes to Snowy. Can she get out in time? She will not get out in time before Critical Velocity starts her scoring pass. Jammer covered back on helmet. Coming out of turn number two on the outside, being held up by now three Dublin blockers, including Chancleta, including Lana Payne, and a third.
Oh, look at that amazing work from the blockers from Naptown, clearly containing Snowy for the moment, but Snowy found once again the resources to get on the inside of the track just before turn four and get the lead jammer position for Dublin.
And that's Chancleta and Lana Payne doing an excellent job of holding critical velocities on the outside, now going up the middle, shrugs off and jukes off a blocker, skipping the hop, and that's a grand slam for Dublin, Fred.
This is the start of the show for Snowy, apex jump for Snowy, and she doesn't have enough.
Pack held up with the from switching between turns number four and turns number three. The pivot for Dublin Chancleta in to try and help out offense for Snowy. Not quite get, there's the block trying to get around Shiva Diva, not having much luck, but Diva will be sent off to the triple eight penalty box. Jam clock now under 30 seconds, but huge opening in the inside lane, marking a perfect 10 for Snowy.
Dublin seems to have a bit more spirits here at the end of that first half. Less than 40-point difference now, and Snowy is still making the show here.
15 points on the jam. Star has been passed. Your active scorer for the Tornado Sirens is now number five, Trudy Bautry. Jam will be called. Naptown's Tornado Sirens will sneak in for 5 points, making it 85. Dublin Charter Team 51.
It's not the highest number of points scored on one single jam. It was by Naptown on 23 points. But clearly, Snowy is a very nice jammer to watch. He's always concerned with the show also.
Clock will be stopped. Team time, or I believe that's the
official review, I think.
I do believe you're correct. I do see the official review hand signal.
Yep.
Being made by our jam timer, that's being shown that it's Dublin's official review. We'll wait for the signal from our head ref, Silence of the Jams, for an update.
In the meantime, just before the content of the official review, let me talk to you about Radio Wheels from RiderScase.com. WFTA playoffs are sponsored in part by the Radio Halo No in 99A and 101A harnesses. A bit of statistics, 18 jams so far, 8 leads by Naptown, 9 leads by Dublin, so Dublin leads the lead, 3-point jam each.
And I think we have words from Silence of the Jams, or waiting for it. He's talking things over with his officials in the huddle and center track, and maybe that was just used for a team timeout.
Maybe it was used for a team timeout, or maybe they asked for an official review. Yeah, no, it was used for a team timeout, I think.
Not a bad move. You know, buy a little time, get your little rest there, and you still, if it gets close, you still have, between the two teams, 5 team timeouts reserved for later in the game. And now we're back underway with jam number 19, Scorpio Pathic for Naptown and Bloody Harry for Dublin.
Less than 2 minutes on the clock before the end of that first half. It's just jam number 19. And who between Scorpio Pathic and Bloody Harry is going to take the lead? It's Bloody Harry for Dublin.
Fred, if I'm not mistaken, the last 3 jams have resulted in lead jammer for the Dublin Charter Team as the pack held up in turn number 1. As Harry tries to hang on, avoid a cutting the track, re-enters behind number 84, Wham Bam, the pivot for the Tornado Sirens, moves the Dublin brace triangle almost to the entrance of straightaway number 2, calls it off before Scorp can engage and score. No points for Naptown and the 4 points for Dublin.
We said it 2 jams ago, Dublin appears to be a bit more consistent. Once again, we like using that word. At the end of that first half, 30-point difference sharp right now. 55 for Dublin, 85 for Naptown.
Jam number 20 about to get underway. We're under 1 minute on the period clock. It will be Made in America and Thea jamming for Naptown and Dublin, respectively.
Don't you think that Made in America might be the best derby name in the playoffs in Pittsburgh?
It may very well. She may very well have that one, Fred. I have precious little argument to make with you on that, but certainly making a name for herself with the start is Thea for Dublin. Uh-oh. Shakes off a couple of blockers, but opens up the inside lane for Made in America to get the call.
Made in America was very clever because she let Thea take forward here, opening the door on the inside, and she immediately rushed to it. Good job by Made in America.
Blocking out of bounds play will go against Malibu's Stacy as Maiden on her first scoring pass of the jam. Hit out and drawn back by Chariot of Fire is Thea. And Maiden pushing against that braced Dublin triangle. And finally, it's the captain having to come in on the block. I believe it's crashing to you, but still holding on desperately is Changreta. The weapon trying to hold the line, has to let her on go, gets the penalty, and that's the grand slam for Made in America.
The star pass for Dublin, Stabana has the helmet cover, and the clock went 2-0. It is going to be the last jam of the first half, and in the meantime, Made in America once again is giving a show here.
And that's 10 points already on the jam as the pack held up in turn number three, going to turn number four.
Oh.
And sticks the landing, so that's 15 points on the jam. And Fred, it's clear the instructions from the bench from Naptown, strike a knife in the heart of Dublin to end this half.
And they've reached a triple digit. Naptown 100, Dublin 55, and Made in America is on fire. Your defense is terrified.
Just under 3 seconds left in jam time regulation. Can she get enough for one more point? Sneaks
wow.
in for one more point, and Fred beats her own single jam record for the game with 21 points on the jam.
55 for Dublin, 106 for Naptown. Halftime. Once again, we've said it multiple times during the first half, but Naptown seems to be, let's say the word, better than Dublin on the first half.
Well, as you pointed out earlier, my colleague, consistency. Consistency, the name of the game in this third place bronze medal game. And consistency has favored more the Tornado Sirens of Naptown Roller Derby, more so than Dublin's charter team of Dublin Roller Derby. We'll look to see what happens more in our second period of play. For Shut the Fret Up, I'm Vince Hannity. We'll see you back here for the second half of this third place game for your 2017 International WFTDA Division II Playoffs and Championships. Roller Derby fans, thank you for watching and thank you for listening to this incredible third place game for your 2017 International WFTDA Division II Playoffs and Championships. I'm Vince Hannity. He's Shut the Fret Up. You are watching the third place game between the Naptown Tornado Sirens and the Dublin Charter Team. You saw at the beginning of the game the medals displayed. Those medals will be shown and awarded to their respective teams tonight on Facebook Live on the WFTDA's Facebook page at approximately 9:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Fred, you've got some statistics for us. What do you have for us,
yeah,
sir?
Interesting stats, thanks to our producer. On the first half, Naptown led 9 times, Dublin led 10 times. Naptown gave up 3 power jams, Dublin gave up 3 power jams. 6 scoreless jams for Naptown, 9 scoreless jams for Dublin. 2 star pass for Naptown, 3 star pass for Dublin. 2-0-0 jams for each, actually, but yet you have 51 point difference at halftime. Yesterday, if you followed the playoffs, Naptown played Dublin. At halftime, Naptown was 75, Dublin was 85. 30 points less for Dublin today, before the start of the second half. Clearly, something had changed. We checked it at halftime together on flat tracks. On the Derby season so far, Dublin has played 12 games. And for Naptown, they have played 8 games. So 4 games difference is quite important. If you add up the jet lag, if you add up the context of it, it seems to me, but I may be mistaken, it seems to me that Dublin seems to be a bit more tired than yesterday and a bit more tired than Naptown.
Well, Fred, an interesting point and an interesting dimension you bring up. Additionally, what we're seeing on the track so far in the first period, the question is it the fact that the Tornado Sirens have simply solved the pack of the Dublin Charter Team? We'll find out more as the second half gets underway. Dashing Trudy Stowe and Scorpio Pathic for Dublin and Naptown, respectively. If you're just joining us, that is Naptown in the black jerseys, Dublin in the blue jerseys. Front of the scrum is Naptown trying to hold back Snowy. Hit out and draw back courtesy of the pivot. That is, of course, 0-7, Cherry on a Fire. And now desperately trying to hold back Scorpio Pathic, the three-wall up front for Dublin.
Dublin Walls appear to be a bit stronger here at the beginning of the second half, even if Scorpio Pathic is taking the lead for Naptown here.
Well, credit, they forced at least over 30 seconds for Scorpio Pathic to try and break the pack to get lead jammer, but she will now start on her first scoring pass. Hits into a blocker and falls over, no penalties, deemed all legal contact.
Have you seen the way Scorpio Pathic was resisting the attacks from number 169, Brudol Ilocock? And she takes another five for Naptown. It's the triple one for Naptown and the double five for Dublin.
And over a full minute, and Snowy still yet to break the pack on the initial pass. And powers past Dirty Knees Louise, and that will be a perfect 10 for number 237, Scorpio Pathic of the Tornado Sirens.
Scorpio Pathic seems not to have enough of from points on that jam. She has already scored 10 points for the Naptown jammer, but she doesn't seem to be willing to end up that jam, right?
Not quite yet. Pippa hit out and draw back on Scorpio Pathic, trying to hold the line, joined by two additional blockers, including Valdemort with the point of the brace triangle, and Scorpio Pathic will call it off before Snowy, or the pivot, can finally engage. But at this point, Fred, the damage done, a 12-0 jam to start off the period.
Exactly. Scorpio Pathic is holding the line, and this time she was on time, calling off that jam for Naptown. Did you get it?
I see what you did there.
Okay, thank you.
That will be jam number two of period number two. If I see correctly, that will be Mania with the star for your Dublin charter team. Yes, and that's Made in America. Naptown living and dying by that four jammer rotation, but a hit out and drawback takes Maiden into turn number three. Can Manny take the advantage? No! Maiden dancing on those toe stops on the inside lane. Two for two for Naptown.
Second lead jammer position in a row for Naptown on the previous jam. Naptown scored 12 points. Let's see how Maiden America is going to deal with it on that jam number two. She has just been recycled here by Dublin Wall, and she's back to fight, trying to get on the inside, but good work by the blocker number eight, Chancleta for Dublin.
Chancleta, the weapon, desperately trying to hold back Made in America, the longtime veteran for your Tornado Sirens. Hit out and draw back by Cherry out of Fire slows down Mania. Jam now with 50 seconds gone. Mania still yet to break the pack on the initial pass to the penalty box is Chancleta, your triple eight penalty box. Pack now moving into turn number three. Oh. And that will be an elbow penalty. We'll send off. Somebody's going to the triple eight penalty box, and I believe that's going to be Chariot of Fire of the Tornado Sirens.
Yeah, I was just about to praise once again Chariot of Fire defending on Mania when she committed the penalty. But clearly, Chariot of Fire is a huge asset in Naptown Walls.
Indeed, and part of the penalty trouble for Chariot of Fire as far as a block. But Fred, perhaps we can talk about some of these blocker issues for the Dublin Charter team.
Five penalties for Chancleta in for Dublin. She is two penalties away from the foul out. And once again, it seems to confirm the theories that we had at halftime, because the more you're tired, the more you commit penalties.
Indeed. Jam number three of the second period, Bloody Harry with a star for Dublin. Darth Blue, number 501 for the Tornado Sirens. But there's Bloody Harry breaking the pack and getting the call against a 3-1 pack disadvantage.
This is the first time that Dublin has taken the lead on the second half, but look at that, the jammer from Naptown, number 501, Darth Blue, went out of the pack very quickly, putting pressure on Dublin, and that's why Dublin called that jam off. We will once again, I'm always repeating it at every game, we will never underline the importance of a jammer when you're not lead to get out of the pack rather quickly to put pressure on the lead jammer. And this is exactly what happened.
And Fred, I think part of the problem that we're seeing is that Dublin cannot just hold those Naptown jammers in the pack at all. They've got to hold back Scorpio Pathic on this jam as she jams against Thea. Inside lane, wide open turn number one, lead jammer Naptown.
On the inside, just in between turn one and turn two, we have Scorpio Pathic now in control of that jam number four.
Hop, skip, and a jump. Does she land the She sticks the landing for a grand slam. Pack finally coming out of turn number two, going into turn number three. Thea with the star stash, Tornado Sirens, not fooled at all, but she will draw the pack out of play and finally break the pack.
On the first half, we remember Made in America on fire, but this time Scorpio Pathic is giving the show here.
Scorpio Pathic now, if I'm not mistaken, Fred, 21 points in two jams to start off the second period.
It seems to me, if I'm not mistaken, that Dublin hasn't scored any points since the beginning of the second half, whereas Naptown scored a bit less than 30 points.
My learned colleague counts the score quite correctly as we go into jam number five. Made in America and Dashing Trudy Snow, Naptown and Dublin respectively. And inside, once again, Made in America, lead jammer Naptown.
Another proof, once again, that could confirm our theories about Dublin's fatigue is that, look at that, you only have one blocker left for Dublin on the track. And Made in America cannot ask for more.
And number 74, Stabak, it's just enough on the inside lane for the hit out and the drawback. But the outside lane, Stabak with a swing and a miss, and that's a grand slam for Made in America.
Made in America dodging the attack from the Dublin blocker. It's 142 for Naptown, 55 for Dublin. And Made in America resists and shoulders her way through the pack on the inside to score even more points for Naptown, and she doesn't seem to quit. And she doesn't quit. Made in America continues on the fifth scoring trip now.
20 points gone in the jam as the pack hangs in turn number two. Here comes Made in America inside late. Where is the defense from Dublin as the jam is called? And once again, Fred, Made in America sets a single jam scoring record for this game. 24 points on the jam, and the clock will stop.
This is the official record in that game of the highest number of points scored on one single jam. 24 points by Made in America. Clearly, Naptown has sped up, and for the moment, Dublin cannot follow.
Unofficially, shut the Fred up. Five jams to start the second period. Four lead the jammer calls out of five for Naptown on a 50-0 scoring run.
And it's now 101 points difference. Dublin 55, Naptown 156.
Well, the Dublin Charter team has certainly been the cardiac kids and given us many, many great and exciting moments and exciting conclusions to these games here at our 2017 International WFTDA Division II Playoffs and Championships. But at this point, shut the Fred up, we have to kind of wonder, is there anything left in the tank for Dublin?
Is there anything? It's the pride, actually. They just here, and they are so much delighted to be here, and they will give everything they have left on that first leg of the doubleheader between America and Europe, because the second leg is just right after with the final between Paris and Boston.
Indeed, our 8 o'clock Eastern Time game for our Division II Championship, but we're back underway. Jam number 6, number 17, Critical Velocity for Naptown, and once again, number 95, Mania for Dublin.
Naptown seems to be more and more confident. You know why? Because when you are confident, you tell your relief jammer, yeah, okay, you can go. I think that Critical Velocity has made maybe her first appearance on the track as a jammer. I'm not sure. On the second half, that's sure, but I'm not sure on the first half.
And a high block will send Critical Velocity to the 888 penalty box. Power jam for Mania, but she had done a star stash, so no lead jammer. Jam must go the full 2 minutes. Bouncing off of Naptown jammers will clear the pack. And there is the 5 points to finally get Dublin scoring in the second period.
She appeared once, the Critical Velocity appeared once in the first half, once in the second half. And when you're a relief jammer, you are more likely to make penalties. And this is exactly what she did. She stand in the penalty box. The power jam is about to end. Mania, for the moment, made the most of it by having scored 5 points And five more for Dublin with Mania.
And she'll also send off number five, Trudy Botchery, to the 888 penalty box on a forearm penalty, dissecting Naptown Tornado Siren blockers. Pack holding up in turn number one, engages for another scoring pass, knocks off her Jammer Star. She'll be awarded points by the Jam Ref, but the Jammer Star now being guarded by Tornado Sirens on the apex to turns number one and two. You might be able to see it on our WFDA.TV screen, trying to get down there and pick up the star cover.
And this is it. Mania has picked up the helmet cover now. And she is still going on that jam number six. She has already scored 14 points so far, 69 for Dublin. And three more for Dublin. So it's going to be 17 for Dublin and 0 for Naptown. And I believe that with 17 points, Mania has the record for Dublin of the highest number of points scored on one single jam. So the last one was 15.
Scoring on Naptown Tornado Sirens, 156. Dublin Charter Team, 72. 20 minutes, 10 seconds, and counting left in regulation. Power start formation for Dublin.
Oh, it's 18 points. 18 points on the previous jam for Mania.
Bloody Harry with the star for Dublin's charter team. Dublin finally bringing the offense, and now consecutive lead jammer. Well, not consecutive, because there was no lead jammer for Mania on that last one, but a chance for consecutive scoring jams in this period, Fred.
I told you that Dublin was going to give everything they have left on those playoffs, and they, once again, they seem to be a bit more solid, and a bit more also risk-taking on the last two jams.
Well, they will have to scout a record comeback if they want a hope of catching this team. Hit out and drawback by Cherry out of fire and out of the penalty box for 888 is number 17, Critical Velocity, once again jamming for Naptown as Pack held up in turn number one. Inside lane, trying to get some openings for Bloody Harry.
And Bloody Harry saw it coming on the inside, and she passes just between turn three and turn four to score five more points for Dublin.
Cherry out of fire now with a star pass to her, the active scorer for your Tornado Sirens, will clear the pack coming out of turn number three. She'll get four on the pass for Naptown. The instructions clear for the Dublin bench to have Bloody Harry keep on going. But at that point, she will call it off and sneak in for one more point to make it 6-4 advantage Dublin.
Let's shout out to our sponsors for the WFTDA playoffs. But for example, Atom Skates, atomskates.com. New backpacks by Atom are available now. Carry everything you need in one place. New full skate packages at great prices. Something for every budget. And colored Pilot Falcon plates are the best option for the best price.
Jam number eight underway. Scorpiopathic for Naptown. Thea for your Dublin charter team. Hit out and drawback on the outside is Scorpiopathic. Dublin at the rear of the scrum. Naptown up front. Dublin trying to bring some offense in the inside lane. Still not enough to break that Tornado Siren brace. Turns it into a horizontal wall. Trying to shift back and forth. And that is Chancleta, I believe, trying to run the bridge. Yes. Thea now up against two blockers. Trying to come out of turn number two.
Oh, good job by number 51 for Naptown. Bruzy Ricardo recycling Thea to the back of the pack, allowing Scorpiopathic to take the lead for Naptown.
Well, credit to those Naptown Tornado Siren blockers. They seem to have a knack for hitting out and drawing back, and the star has been passed. Once again, Stabba now your active scorer for Dublin's charter team, but Scorpiopathic will clear on the inside lane of turn two and call it off for four.
Let's have a look, it's been a long time, at the penalty board, because it has evolved. Chancleta is now one penalty away from the foul outs, with six penalties for the Dublin blocker, four penalties for Mania, four penalties for Pippa, three penalties for Marie-Bruce Tassi, and three for Dodenise Lewis and Brew, and for Naptown, three from Cherry Autofire, three for Critical Velocity, and that's all. There's a clear difference of penalties between Naptown and Dublin.
Indeed, Snowy now the jammer, lead jammer of record for this jam, but swallowed back up by the pack, taken into turn number four as Made in America fights her way past the three brace, midway between the jammer line and the pivot line. Trying to get through is Snowy, A still lead, but stuck in the pack, being held up by Diva, finally gets clear. After about, let's call it 35 seconds of the jam.
Snowy.
And a back block penalty, and that is going to go against Made in America, and it's a power jam, Fred.
It is a power jam for Snowy, and let's see what she's going to make out of it. Snowy is in control and in a power jam situation and passes on the outside of the pack, scoring 5 more points for Dublin.
Tornado Sirens at the front of the pack, a pivot towards the back being isolated. It's number 5, Trudy Botchery, for your Tornado Sirens. Now coming up, playing defense as 1980 Shiva Diva runs the front of the point. Dublin trying to clear her out, not having much luck. Number 16 crashing to you, the captain for the Tornado Sirens, holding back Snowy. Snowy sending blockers on offense, but just like that, out of nowhere, Main America flies by with an apex hop on the initial pass. Snowy's got to call it off.
Snowy cutting off after having scored more points for Dublin. It's now 88 for Dublin, but hey, Derby people, this was Made in America once again making the show.
It is indeed a show when Made in America dons the star and gets on the track.
Triple Eight is a proud sponsor of the WFTA playoffs and of the penalty box, protecting Derby since day one.
Once again, Mania with a star for Dublin, Darth Blue with a star for Naptown. Naptown at the rear of the scrum, Dublin up front. A fourth blocker coming out of the box, a lot of pain, trying to help out with an offensive block to spring open a lane for Manny, but a hit out and draw back to turn number 4. Back now between the jammer and pivot lines. Naptown reforming up front, trying to hold back. Ooh, Dark Blue trying to hold on to the jersey for blocker, but couldn't quite stay upright and inbounds. And enough on the toe stop for Manny to get through and get the call, Fred.
Mania, lead jammer for Dublin. Once again, Dublin is giving everything at the end of that second half. And Mania is in control of that jam number 10.
And those 3 points, no points for Naptown, brings us to 164-91. Naptown leading over Dublin with under 14 minutes left in regulation. And the question, Fred, is there enough time for Dublin to mount the full comeback?
There are. What I know is that there is 13 minutes and 45 seconds left, and a bit more than 70 points, 73 points difference. It seems difficult to me for Dublin to get back at Naptown, but hey, you never know with those players who played magnificently on those 3 days.
And playing magnificently with the star is Bloody Harry and Scorpio Pathic for Dublin and Naptown, respectively. And that's Scorpio Pathic coming out of turn number 2, lead jammer Naptown.
Especially when Naptown is starting to get their head out of the water for the last 2 jams. And Scorpio Pathic is in control and is even more in control as it is a power, power, power jam for Naptown.
Exactly what Dublin's charter team did not need at this point in space and time, as here comes Scorpio Pathic on a second scoring pass. And I believe that is the seventh Triple Eight penalty box trip for number 8, Chancleta. She is standing, that's the jammer standing up. Once she stands up, if she stands to the side of the penalty box, we'll know for sure she has fouled out of this game.
That's quite an important loss for Dublin. Chancleta is a key player within Dublin walls, and she has reached the 7 penalties. And in the meantime, Scorpio Pathic has reached the double 7 points this time with 14 points so far. Oh, almost on for the apex jump for Scorpio Pathic. She looks at the bench, having the hand on the head and calling that jam off. Oh, 2 points, late call, 3 points, I believe. 3 points, yes, late call for Scorpio Pathic. 3 points for Dublin, 16 points for Naptown.
So that brings us to Naptown Tornado Sirens 181 as a 17th point comes in as a late show up. Dublin with 3 points at 94, 11 minutes, 39 seconds left in regulation.
RiderScares.com, WFTA playoffs are sponsored by the Rider Halo Experience World Class Edging.
Made in America once again with the star for the Tornado Sirens. Dublin's Turner team will jam Thea outside lane. It is Made in America getting the call, Fred.
Made in America is lead jammer on that jam number 12 for Naptown, paving their way to a possible victory on the final for the third place.
Maiden gets part way, calls it off. Will be awarded one, maybe 2 points.
Ah, 2 points. Well, that's still points.
Yeah, that's,
right?
That's
indeed, still points.
Those are still good points. Those are valid for any roller derby game, sir.
Let's have a look at what S1Helmets.com has to offer. The S1 Lifer Helmet, best fit plus best protection, made for roller derby. Get a lifer, be a lifer.
Snowy with a star for Dublin on the line for the Tornado Sirens. Number 17, critical velocity.
And dashing through the snow, a.k.a. Snowy, and for Dublin.
Dirty Knees Louise will force a cutting the track on critical velocity. Another jammer penalty, so another lead jammer call for Snowy and a Dublin power jam.
And what we said last time is still valid, since critical velocity is a relief jammer. Last time she appeared on track at the start of a jam, she went to the triple A penalty box. And here, once again, when critical velocity appeared on the track, she went to the penalty box also.
Matchup favoring Dublin so far in the second period. Snowy now on her second scoring pass. Dublin choosing to go passive as Naptown rotates its blockers, now sends its pivot, number 84, Wham Bam, to run the bridge to keep players in play. Critical velocity now back out of the penalty box and up the inside, perfect 10 for Snowy.
The triple digit is made by Dublin. 104 for Dublin, 183 for Naptown. So far, Naptown has had 8 lead jams, Dublin 5 lead jams, and 3 power jams this half for Dublin, making the most of it. Snowy scores 2 more points on the last scoring trip. 106 for Dublin, 183 for Naptown.
Just over 9 minutes left in regulation.
And let's have a look once again at S1Helmets.com. Durable, functional, stable, the S1 Pro knee pads are built for roller derby.
About to enter jam number 14 of period number 2. It will be Scorpio Pathic for Naptown and Mania for Dublin. Scorp drawn back into turn number 4 by the Dublin blocking crew.
Strong walls, but Mania takes the lead on the inside. Dublin is going to give everything. I mean, you can always count on Dublin for giving everything they have inside to play roller derby.
Here's the problem, though. Dublin cannot hold Scorpio Pathic in the pack, but they will hold her long enough off the first scoring pass for Manny to get 4 points and now set up for a second scoring pass. Barrels into the Tornado Siren. Brace gets back upright, beats at least one Tornado Siren blocker up. Tries to stay inbound, goes outside, and upright, inbounds, mark it, 8 points on the jam.
This is what Dublin is. This is what Dublin is. You will never see them giving up. Even if they have nothing inside, they will give everything on the track, and Mania is having a wonderful jam here.
The fighting spirit against superior forces. I didn't want the mark of the Irish.
I didn't want to use that word because it might appear to be a cliche for me here, but you're right, Vince. You're right. Dublin is having that fighting spirit at the end of that second half.
And the jam will be called and will go 13-4 advantage Dublin Charter team, making our score 187 Naptown, Dublin 119.
Yes, and you know why we say that, because the audience is never wrong. The audience is never wrong. The audience is clapping hard for Dublin on the last jam. 120 for Dublin, 187 for Naptown. It's going to be Bloody Harry jamming for Dublin. And 2 blockers down for Dublin.
And once again, Made in America with the knife in the heart of Dublin, lead jammer for the Naptown Tornado Sirens.
I don't know whether we realize how lucky we are to have such talented jammers on each team. We have Made in America, we have Scorpiopathic, we have Snowy, we have Mania. What pleasure to see those skaters.
Indeed, my friend, as the pack sets up and we start on our second scoring pass for Made in America coming out of turn number two, straightaway number two. Harry still held up, but will break the pack on Harry's initial pass.
Bloody Harry is in her first scoring trip now. Made in America saw it and immediately called off that jam after having scored four more points for Naptown. 5 minutes and 55 seconds to go. Just in time for me to talk to you again about the S1 Life Advisor helmet. Next level protection.
Once play resumes, it will be jam number 16. It will be Thea for your Dublin Charter team, but the clock will stop.
It's going to be a team timeout by Naptown. Osborne Naptown, yes, indeed. A team timeout.
A little surprised it's Naptown calling the team timeout at this point, Fred.
They may want to rest people a bit because they've given so much energy on defending against Dublin, especially on the last jams. On the last, I would say, five jams, Dublin has sped up a bit. We
sure.
were saying that Dublin was giving everything and all that, so maybe Naptown bench coach wants to fix things up a bit.
Fair point, indeed. Fair point.
Let's tell everyone. Let's tell everyone about 888 new helmets that protect against rotational violence with MIPS patented brain protection system. And you know what? After those playoffs, you can play on Wftda. Get in the game with the 2017 Wftda Playoffs Bracket Challenge hosted by Debbie on Toast. Easily select your bracket choices and compete against people from around the world for prizes from Radar, S1 Elements, Wftda.tv, and the Apex. Go to Wftda.tv now and click Play the 2017 Bracket Challenge to get started.
Jam number 16 underway, Darth Blue for Naptown. One step and gone on the outside. Lead jammer Darth Blue, friend.
Can we say that the team timeout was beneficial to timeout?
I believe we can,
yes,
sir.
Yes, indeed. Yes, indeed. Darth Blue is controlling that jam number 16. Another interesting stat. Oh,
Darth Blue. On one skate! On one skate!
Showtime in Pittsburgh. And Naptown is reaching the 200. 200 for Naptown, 120 for Dublin. I was about to say that an interesting fact is that on this second half, for the moment, 16 jams and less than 5 minutes to go. That means that the jams lasted a bit longer than the first half.
I believe you are correct on that one, sir.
Here we go for jam number 17, Scorpiopathic versus Dashing Street Snow, a.k.a. Snowy. For Dublin.
Well, Dublin certainly had a lot of luck with Snowy, but she'll get hung up by Naptown on that inside lane, trying to get a blocker to help her out on offense. Isolates now to a two-wall for the Tornado Sirens, but buys enough time to sneak around and slingshot on the outside. Scorpiopathic getting that lead jammer call, Fred.
Scorpiopathic in control on that jam number 17, and once again, taking the benefits of the team timeouts one jam ago, Naptown seems to get the grip again on the game after the five jam momentum for Dublin. And here Scorpiopathic calls off that jam after having scored only 1 point because she saw that the jammer for Dublin was about to come at her. Vince, can you ask me a question?
What is the meaning of life?
No, because this is 42. But in what do I believe? Ask me the question.
Well, what do you believe in? Shut the Fred up.
We believe in road derby, in all that all species should be saved. We believe in non-conformity. We believe in many things. And the Women Flash Track Derby Association is proud to introduce new international giving program to support global change. We believe. Visit wftda.com/donate to purchase and to donate for the United Nations and the WFTDA. And in the meantime, Made in America takes the lead for Naptown. on those lost jams of the game.
Shut the fret up when the recap and the tale of this game is told. We cannot overstate and overemphasize the importance of Made in America to this Tornado Siren strategy.
You know what? Made in America has put one finger on the MVP title, maybe?
I believe you might be correct, sir.
Let's tune in after the final to check who's going to be MVP for the award ceremony.
And you can watch that on Facebook Live at the conclusion of tonight's championship game around 9:30 p.m. Eastern Time.
Yep, just before the after party, because it's also part of Florida Derby, you know?
You are quite correct, sir.
Made in America, in the meantime, has scored 9 points for Naptown. And Naptown is approaching the 100-point difference, 90-point difference so far. 120 for Dublin, 210 for Naptown. It's going to be a clear victory for Naptown, even if Dublin, we said it like a gazillion times, gave everything they had on the track, never giving up.
Well, certainly giving everything she has is number 74, Stabba, who is now the active scorer, managed to sneak in for four points, and that will be a team timeout, the third and final team timeout for Dublin's charter team. Clock will stop, 2 minutes, 1 second, Naptown 215, Dublin 124.
I've talked to many Dublin players during those 3 days, and many of them told me that they were so happy to be here. They were so happy to be here in Pittsburgh. They weren't supposed even to come, and they were invited the very last days before the playoffs. And they were seeded number 16, and God, they are so happy to participate in that final for the third place.
We'll finish no lower than fourth after coming in as the lowest seed of the weekend.
That is an amazing experience for them, because this is the first participation in those playoffs. And that might be a difference made with Naptown, because Naptown played in Division 1 playoffs last year.
Indeed, Naptown actually making championships in 2012 and 2013, making the field of eight in championships in Atlanta in 2012 by defeating the Dirty South Derby Girls of Atlanta Roller Derby.
I mean, Naptown joined Wftda in 2007, 2016, 10, 2015, 3rd, 2014, 6th, 2013, 4th. They are an experienced league. Dove Blue versus Bloody Harry for Dublin on what is to be maybe the last jam of the game, as both clocks are synchronized. That's quite rare. And Bloody Harry is taking the lead for Dublin.
Harry on the first scoring pass, hit out, going by the pivot line by a Tornado Siren blocker, who will report to the 888 penalty box. Now coming back in, coming into turn number one. Now two Tornado Sirens to beat outside. We'll get it, and we'll get the Grand Slam.
It's the first lead jammer position for Dublin in five jams, and Bloody Harry is in her second scoring trip now. Oh, good assist from Valdemort, and Bloody Harry gets control of it and scores more points, 10 points, two Grand Slams for Dublin. And Bloody Harry is in her third scoring trip now.
Period clock and jam clock synchronized under 1 minute. Around the outside of Shiva Diva, 15 points on the jam.
Until the very end of the game, Dublin will die on it. We'll die on it. They will die on it.
The spirit of the people of Dublin and the spirit of the Irish is to never stop fighting.
Definitely, and Bloody Harry won't stop fighting. She has scored 15 points so far, and she's in control. And Wham Bam has the helmet cover right now, and is now in the scholarship. And this is the end of that jam with 11 seconds remaining. Will we have another jam?
Well, unless Dublin decides to use its official review as a team timeout.
4, 3, 2, 1. And this is the end of that game on the unofficial score of 215 for Naptown, 144 for Dublin. Naptown will end up number 3 of this 2017 International WFTDA Division 2 Playoffs and Championships.
Credit to the Naptown Tornado Sirens. Shut the Fred up. Came in as the 12 seed, ranked number 53, Division 2 of the Women's Flat Track Derby Association. Came back from a loss last night to Dublin and a loss this morning to Boston for a win and for the bronze medal and third place this weekend.
The brain that they have, the brain that they have here, they never gave up. You said it. They lost against Dublin by 3 points. It could have been a hard blow for them. They could have let everything. They lost against Boston by huge this morning. They could have given up everything, but no. They came here, Naptown, and they bet Dublin this time to take the bronze medal at the 2017 International WFTDA Division II Playoffs and Championships.
Congratulations to the Naptown Tornado Sirens getting the bronze medals. You'll see that at the medal ceremony tonight on Facebook Live on the WFTDA's Facebook page. Start will be at approximately 9:30 p.m. Eastern Time. And in addition to that, we'll be awarding our silver and gold medals for our Division II champions at the conclusion of our next game, as well as our tournament MVP.
Exactly. Can you believe that we have had so far 29 games? 29 games. It was amazing. I mean, the crowd here in Pittsburgh was going crazy yesterday and the day before yesterday. And on social media, the people were going mental when posting Jeff off breathing, nervosity and all that. We've had amazing playoffs and championships so far.
It has been an amazing weekend in Pittsburgh, brought to you by the Women's Flat Track Derby Association and our hosts, Steel City Roller Derby.
Oh, yeah.
So thank you to all. Thank you to watching and to listening to all our international WFTDA Division II playoffs and championship action for this weekend. We do have one more game left to play.
What a game.
At 8 p.m. Eastern Time for the championship, it will be Boston and Paris.
Let's see what's going to happen. W people, bye-bye, and stay tuned for the final of this 2017 International WFTDA D2 Playoffs and Championships.
Indeed.